I grew up in Baghdad, Iraq, into a Shia Muslim family. I was very devoted Muslim. I was trying to please my mom. At the age of 14, 15 years old, I went to my mom and I told her I don't believe in Islam anymore. And she was very upset with me and she said, this is not right and you need to go to your room and read the Quran more and ask Allah to come to you and help you to understand Islam a little bit more. And I did that and I never had any peace about it. At the age of 17, we moved, my family and I, we moved to Lebanon and we lived in a Christian neighborhood. And I remember I asked a few people that were working with me and I asked them, I knew that they were wearing a cross and I asked them about their church and where do they go. And I started reading a lot of books about different religions. I wanted to study different religions from Christianity to Buddhism to different books. And I remember I read a book by Josh McDowell, More Than a Carpenter. And I remember in that book, he was talking about Jesus and what Jesus did on the cross. And from that moment, I just fell in love with that book and I just wanted to know more about it and more about Jesus. And I remember one day around New Year's, they were playing, you know, the Passion of Christ movie, and that was my first time watching the movie. I remember crying just watching the movie and watching how Jesus was walking and carrying his own cross, and they were whipping him and they were just spitting on him, and yet he was still loving them. And that's the kind of love I was looking for. My family and I, we came here to the U.S. as refugees back in 2007. I remember I was going through a lot of depression and anxiety, and that's because in my childhood, one of my best friends, they killed him in the name of Allah because he was not practicing Islam. And so I remember I went to the psychologist and I asked him about the book that I read, and I saw that he had a cross in his office, and I told him about my life and what I've gone through, and he brought a book and he opened that book, and that book was the Holy Bible. And I remember he opened the Bible, and the first thing he opened was Matthew 11:28-29, where it says, come to me, all who you worry, and I'll give you rest. And I remember from that moment I just felt like I wanted to study that book, I wanted to read it, I wanted to get one. And I asked him, I was like, can I have one? And before I even finished, he just gave it to me. He's like, this is a gift for you. And I want you to go back home and ask God to reveal himself to you and ask him who he is to you and just to reveal himself. I told him, I said, I don't know how to pray or who to pray to. And he said, just ask God. He said, just say, God, if you're real, reveal yourself to me. I remember that night, I was just in a lot of pain and I was just scared. I remember I went to bed that night and in the middle of the night I had a dream and Jesus came to me through a dream. And I was sitting in a very bright room and I was sitting in a chair with my head down, and I remember a man walking toward me, and I lift my head and I remember seeing hand open with the nails in the middle. And I remember when I knew who he was because I remember watching The Passion of Christ, and I remember that was Jesus when he was on the cross. And so I just remember sitting there, and he came toward me and he said, will you trust me? Will you give your life to me and I'll give you a new life? And I remember that night, I was so happy. I was trying to get up from bed, and I woke up and I saw myself sitting in bed. And I had so much peace that night, I couldn't even go back to sleep because I was just so happy. I remember that same day, I went back to the psychologist and I told him, will you please tell me what that dream was and all that. And I remember as I was telling him the story and what happened, he got up from his chair and he said, hallelujah. And that was my first time hearing that word. I was like, what does hallelujah mean? And he came and he gave me a hug and he had tears in his eyes. And I remember he said, your life is never going to be the same from now on. And he sat down with me and he said, will you pray with me and repeat after me? And I did. And that was the day that I trusted Jesus and I gave my life to Jesus back in 2008. From that moment, I just started doing ministry, telling people about Jesus, loving on people, And years and years later, now my relationship with my family is even better than before, especially now that I have children, and you know, my family is very close to me, and I'm very thankful to God that He restored that relationship. And basically that's how God brought me out of the darkness into the light. My name is Steve Bali, and I'm a follower of Jesus Christ.